A new downtown cafe is quickly becoming the bee's knees, and it's not from the caffeine buzz you get from its coffee. Brickhouse Cafe recently opened, and as owner Kory Wright tells CRI, the new eatery option has been a long time coming.
Just to see this place the way it is right now, it's shocking.
The formerly vacant Iowa Hospice building at 212 First Avenue East is the new home of Brickhouse Cafe. New owner Kory Wright and his family started renovating the space earlier this fall. The structure suffered smoke damage from an arson fire in May of 2015. The blaze started in a neighboring building that housed Swim Sporting Goods and Revelations Therapy. Wright is part of a larger effort to revitalize the downtown block for the sake of retail and history.
It was hospice, the last thing that it was. It was all office space. I mean, there was cubicle area all the way through here. And years ago, you'll talk to the older people in town, they'll remember it as the Bon Ton Bakery. So apparently the first 20 feet of this area was where you would purchase your pastries, but everything baking and mixing wise was actually on the second floor.
For generations, the Bon Ton was one, if not the, bakery older residents may remember. The tall man near the center of the photo with a mustache, William Kilpatrick, was the original owner of the Bon Ton. According to information obtained by the Oskaloosa Herald, Kilpatrick opened the confectionery at 212 First Avenue East in the early 1900s. Some may remember Roy Kilpatrick and his brother Harold, who operated the bakery for many years. The Bon Ton closed in 1973.
There was a small elevator. They brought up all the flour and all that stuff upstairs every single day. I've talked to the guys that's done the renovation from this building from 50 years ago, and just to hear the history in it is really cool, and to know that food's back in here after it's been a bakery is pretty neat.
CRI first introduced you to Wright this summer when he built Oskaloosa's first pilot parklet downtown. At that time, he was in discussions of purchasing Hunter's and its cafe. However, those plans fell through with the owners, and Wright brought his future plans to the other side of the square.
After you've been involved with a certain business for 40 plus years of your life, it kind of becomes your identity, and I just don't think maybe it was a situation that they wanted to get away from, and you know, we walked away from there, you know, no hard feelings whatsoever. I still go in there and eat, and you know, they've been in here and they've been super supportive, and I just think they just want to slow down a little bit, and it kind of works even better because now I have my own identity.
The Brickhouse Cafe can seat up to 52 patrons, and there's a meeting room still under construction that will hold 20 to 25 customers. Wright says a three-person crew, including himself, will stick to selling healthy options instead of fried foods.
I've got smoked meats. My pulled pork is amazing. I've got meatball subs, Philly cheesesteaks. I mean, we still got real hearty sandwiches, along with some of our other colder sandwiches as well.
Now remember, Wright wanted outdoor seating options, such as a parklet. He won't have to worry about building an area for that, since Midwest One is renting their outdoor seating area to the Brick House.
Sit anywhere between 20 and 25 people outside. I think once, you know, March hits, we'll be able to utilize that space quite a bit. It'll be more of a permanent space, but we'll have lighting and that sort of thing.
Now, if you're a night owl or an early bird, Brickhouse Cafe may be right up your alley. The business is open from 6:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. Wright also mentioned he is building two studio apartments above the cafe to go along with the other 10 future housing units lining the block.